Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Fairy Fencer F, Advent Dark Forest. On the last episode, the only thing I actually remember is the fact that we got our revival rank up to A. Also, that we're supposed to be here for an event thing. So, let's see if we can figure out our way out of this area. Just a big circle.
What's inside?
Okay, so I'm gonna have to get past that bird to go over here. And there's our event marker. Let's see, how do I get over there? Sit. Go ahead and save here for our insurance. You know. Just in case, you know, the video gets corrupted, something happens, we die and don't want to go all the way back. You know.
Hey, guys. Doesn't it feel like a boss fight is going to happen soon? Man, it's freezing. I might actually catch a cold here.
We need to put those wool undies on again.
I made sure to wear mine. Thanks to Bajas's tailoring skills, they're even long enough to cover my tummy.
It was no trouble. I usually have to remind you to wear underwear anyway.
I'm so jealous. I wish Bajas was my fairy partner so I had someone taking care of me.
Excuse me? Do you know how hard I work keeping you safe?
You guys aren't nervous at all.
Agreed. Do not forget that we're in enemy territory right now.
That's right. This is enemy territory. And soon it will become your gravesite.
She's one of Dorfa's four heavenly czars. She was expecting us.
I was expecting her.
Jeez, you're persistent. I know you guys have a crush on me, but it's starting to feel a little obsessive.
You bastard. Lady Mariana would never be attracted to a hideous cretin like you. We took our precious time spreading rumors about a monster just to lure you all into a trap, and it totally worked.
You spent time spreading rumors that monsters were attacking to lure the group of fencers to take out the monster to save the village? Why didn't you just do something, I don't know, different, like try to spread rumors that make them look like bad people instead of something so stupid like this? Now we just know you're really just evil because you're trying to lure a hero in to save something that's not even... whatever.
That means Alola was duped by your false information, huh?
What an idiot. Remind me to get my money back from her.
Lady Mariana, don't waste your time talking to these pukes. Let's hurry up and kill them already.
Precisely. There's no need to ask pointless questions. The punishment for defying Dorfa is death.
Looks like I gotta do this. There's no other way! This is
again
annoying. Let's go!
What? Ready?
Get ready!
Executing.
Let's go, Eren!
Good
you. Shreds.
I'm
ready! You got this!
New data! You ready?
It's not over yet!
Let's go!
I don't even know why he bothered joining this fight.
Freezing meteor.
Get ready!
Executed soul
ammo! Yahoo!
Let us begin. Let's finish this.
Ready?
I'll show you what I got.
Get ready.
Their eyes.
Can anybody guess what I'm about to do? If you've been following this series so far, you'll know what I'm about to do. Totally worth it.
How strong. If this keeps up.
Are you sure about this, Lady Mariana? This is no place for someone like you to fall.
Seha, Shuho, Anne,
Miss Mariana!
Help us!
What are you thinking, bringing children to a place like this?
Master Sherman ordered it. If it looked like you were going to lose, I was ordered to use them as a diversion.
Why, you?
If you were to fall, someone else would have to take over Dorfa's charity division. All of our ongoing charity work would have to be reviewed and reorganized from scratch. Orphanages cost a lot of money, you know. You understand what I'm saying, don't you?
I must seem quite the fool right now. But I am one of Dorfa's heavenly czars. I don't need such underhanded tactics to defeat rabble such as this.
No, Miss Mariana! You're hurt!
Don't worry, children. Just close your eyes.
I'm ready to fight for you.
I couldn't become a fencer, and Dorfa abandoned me. But you were there to save me, Lady Mariana. It would be my honor to give my life for you.
I really don't feel good about any of this.
True, but we got our own reasons we gotta win. Right, Bang?
Yeah, I guess we just gotta do this.
Lady Mariana, let's go!
Beat you down.
Let's go!
Oh, so you're all back
ready?
Now.
Let's do this.
Jeez.
Executing the Russian Edge.
Release!
My turn.
Honestly, had about enough of things that reset everybody's health.
Here we go.
Because they don't ever reset ours. It's really not a problem, though. Because, it's not gonna make a difference.
Let's go! Found you!
I'll do my best.
Next.
Let's go, eh?
Executing Soul Hunter.
Marissa! Take this!
Ha! Rinse and repeat.
Let us begin. Let's finish this.
Ready?
I can feel the power surging.
I'm ready!
Yeah, no, it wouldn't reach him. Why has it gotta be such a small one? It's no matter.
Ready?
Brace yourself.
I don't know how I feel about this music that's playing right now, though. I don't know how to describe it, but it just feels, odd. Seems too calm. So, I'm just going to basically do the same thing I did last time.
Alright, let's go!
I have no reason to change this pattern. Next turn, if she's not dead.
No dodge. Ready? I'm ready. Yeah. New data. Bahas. Now.
Pretty ready? Simple. She's not doing too well. Begin. Well, she's already targeting me right now. So, let's just go ahead and use this.
Are you ready?
Let's do this.
Because I'm gonna just try to kill her as quickly as possible at this point. It's, she's not a threat. At all.
Get ready.
My turn.
Lady Mariana, I'm sorry. I couldn't, but with my final breath, I could still.
Soggy. Soggy died? Yes. Soggy gave his life in order to protect me and all of you. So now it's our duty to live on for him.
Damn it. Did it really have to end like this? There must have been some way for him to live too.
The man sacrificed himself for his convictions. We must show respect for his decision to die.
Dying for someone else.
When you choose to fight in order to protect others, that choice makes you stronger.
Everyone carries some sort of burden. For him, Lady Mariana's existence must have been paramount.
Yeah, you're right.
Anyway, we should move on. There's no reason for us to linger here.
Yeah, let's head back.
Okay, well, that was simple. It was really simple because, it was really easy. It was very easy.
Hey.
Too easy.
What are you doing here in the middle of the night? I'm gonna catch a cold. What are you praying for?
Isn't there something you want to ask me? When Sherman ambushed us, he was targeting me for a reason.
Oh, that. Well, you shouldn't be worrying about that bastard anyway.
Whatever. Yeah, I don't think Fang was paying too much attention to it in the first place.
Or do you think he was targeting you because of your looks or something? Because that's really vain of you.
I know why Sherman was after me. I should have told you sooner.
What are you talking about?
I am a descendant of the vile god.
Well, this is awkward. I'm gonna pretend I didn't hear you make a terrible joke just now.
No, it's true. If I continue to live, the vile god may be reborn in my future children. Or, even worse, it's possible that the vile god could be revived in my body.
How do you know that?
As a child, I was raised in comfort, wanting for
nothing. That was a little too quick of a switch just then. From the tone and then the music, I think I probably should have let that sit just a little bit longer because the switch was so sudden that it felt a little bit awkward.
One day, I had a dream. In it, the vile god had just been defeated by the goddess and was struggling to be reborn. Then, the vile god began speaking to me directly. He begged me repeatedly to break the seal containing him. When I told my mother about this dream, she went pale and told me the truth. About me, and about my tribe.
A tribe?
My tribe is descended from the vile god. For generations, they've been planning to use their power to take over the world.
That's an unfortunate family history.
Yes. My mother learned this shortly after marrying my father. She left him while I was still in her womb. When my mother finally fell ill, she apologized to me from her deathbed with tears in her eyes. She said, "I'm sorry I birthed you with such a horrific burden. I have heard rumors that other descendants of the vile god, much like my tribe, are scattered throughout the world. These people want to use the power of the vile god to take over the world and reshape it as they see fit. The same blood that flows through their veins resides in me as well."
So?
Huh?
That's exactly what I expected. So, that's the perfect answer to the situation from Fang.
So what do you want to do?
Me?
Do you want to follow the path that they're taking, or do you want to make one for yourself? Duh, that's what he's asking.
I don't care about the vile god, your tribe, or your blood. None of that matters to me. What matters is what you want to do.
Whenever I witness crime or tragedy, whenever I see someone bringing misfortune to others, I feel as if I'm being accused. I feel as if the evil blood flowing through my veins has been condemned. That is why I have committed myself to walking the path of justice, even more than a normal person might. In the search for world peace, I even went so far as to become a fencer. But perhaps my motives are false. Perhaps I was not acting out of concern for the world. Maybe I simply wished to divert my gaze from my own tainted blood. If the blood within me may be used to revive the vile god, perhaps it's best if I just die.
You idiot. What would dying accomplish? You met us because you're supposed to live.
But if the vile god is revived, this world will...
I won't let that happen. I'll beat the crap out of anyone who tries to do that.
Thing.
The vile god doesn't matter, the goddess doesn't matter. Life is life, and I'll protect yours no matter what.
You really are such an...
Now that that's settled, stop worrying about stupid stuff. All you gotta do is be quiet and follow me. Come on, let's go home. You're really gonna catch a cold if you stay here much longer.
Okay. Oh, hey, Aaron. Was she really watching this entire thing?
Washy, wash, wash.
Oh, I was wondering when this was going to pop up. If anybody's seen the opening, you know it was going to be in the game eventually.
Ethel, this isn't too itchy, is it? No. And I'm not scrubbing too hard? It's fine. Huh? Ethel, does Karin always wash your hair for you?
I get shampoo in my eyes, but I do it myself.
You're not a kid, you know. But holy cow, you're skinny. Like, a little too skinny, don't you think?
Indeed. Seeing her like this, she seems quite delicate.
Until she met all of you, Ethel treated eating as a simple mechanical process. She just ate the bare minimum she needed to survive.
I never thought of anything as tasty until lately. Meals were just a necessity. My only duty was to fight.
If that's true, then I'm sure moving forward you will find all sorts of different things to start liking. Food, clothes, people. I pray you'll become fond of many different things.
Why are you talking like that?
I mean, it's only natural to want your friends to be happy, right?
I don't consider you my friends.
Don't worry, she's just embarrassed. That's good. Hey, Tiara, why don't you come over here and we can wash each other's backs?
Hmm? I don't particularly mind, but...
Okay, then get on over here. Here comes a splash! Wow, your skin is so beautiful. It glows like a pearl. And your boobs are the perfect size and shape, too.
Please stop touching me there!
Now, it's nice to have some quality time with just us girls. Wow, the nape of your neck is beautiful, too.
I have nothing to say about this current scene.
And your hair is so shimmery and sparkly.
Wait a moment. It seems rather strange for you to excessively praise me like this. You must have heard my conversation with Fang, and came here to console me.
You caught me.
Mind your own business. I am not so sad that I need to be consoled by the likes of you. You flat-chested busybody.
Huh? Flat-chested? Are you serious? My boobs are way bigger than yours are.
I beg to differ on that one, actually, Aaron.
Are we looking at the same chest? Mine are clearly 3 times the size of yours, if not bigger.
Mine are bigger.
This is a stupid argument.
No, mine are bigger.
Because it's this is a stupid argument.
Can you promise me something?
Anything.
If for some reason, the vile god's blood begins to stir within me...
What?
Please kill me.
What are you talking about? If you really want to die so badly, kill yourself now! Right now! If you can't do that, then live. Live and fight. You're the only one who can fight the vile god's blood that's inside you.
You are right. I'm sorry I even asked.
It's okay. Just don't ever talk about dying again. Got it?
Yes, I understand.
All right, it's Beth time.
I should have expected it.
I don't want to see that.
I should have saw it coming. I should have saw it coming. It was just it was a little too peaceful. It was a little bit too peaceful.
Does she know where the faith drop is by now?
Yeah, you're right. She definitely owes us for selling bad information. Let's see if she'll cut us a deal.
Okay, so we have sub-events. Hey, why is Ethel wearing bunny ears? Ask Karin, it's her hobby. Oh my, is that so? Aren't they cute? Girls are the cutest when they're wearing animal ears. Come to think of it, she made Ethel wear some other type of animal ears before. Yeah, those were cute too. So cute. I'm pretty sure that's not how that was said, but I was reading it without thinking about it. She looks somewhat happy. But I don't get how animal ears make girls the cutest. What are you basing that on? Ethel not cute? No, that's not what I'm saying. Aw, oh, poor thing. She looks so disappointed. Come on, tell her that she's cute. Ethel, you're... Ugh, this is so embarrassing. Why do I gotta say this? Ah, he snapped. I never said she wasn't cute, so don't treat me like the bad guy. Then Ethel is cute. Like I said, I can't really deny that. Honestly, Fang, you should be ashamed of yourself. I can't believe you're unable to properly tell a girl that she is cute. Fang, you treat girls bad. What? Even Ethel's giving me the business? I'm disappointed in you, Fang. Come on, let's just leave him behind. Wow. Why am I being treated like some kind of jerkwad? Wow. Just because you can't actually give a compliment. Which isn't needed. Anything new? Anything new? Okay. We don't need to be there. Lola!
Sorry. I haven't received any information about the faith drop yet.
What? I thought you were doing your job.
Does this faith drop even exist at all? If it does, I'm bound to hear about it eventually. But I do have some other nice information. A cash reward is being offered to anyone who slays this monster.
No, that's fine. I'll come back later. Man, we're in a bind. If Lola doesn't know where it is, I don't know how we're supposed to find it.
I'm thinking that if even a fairy that specializes in gathering intel has no idea, it might be hidden in a very special place.
Fairy? What are you talking about?
You can tell, Fang.
Huh?
What?
Oh, I get it. Never mind, pretend you didn't hear that. Anyway, why don't we try going to the inverted tower?
He couldn't tell. He can't tell. Do you guys, can you tell yet? Come on.
The inverted tower?
She just basically gave it away.
Yeah, the subterranean tower and the inverted tower were supposedly built long ago by a wise and ancient civilization. It's theorized that this civilization's wisdom came directly from the goddess. Which means both structures functioned as shrines where they would worship the goddess.
Gotcha. So, if we're looking for treasure that's connected to the goddess, odds are we'll find it in a place like that. Huh?
Most likely.
This conversation feels strangely familiar to me.
That's right. Before we traveled back to the past, I got some of my memories back at the subterranean tower.
Oh yeah, that's it. So this time, we have to go to the inverted tower. Let's move.
Fang, my darling. Hold up. I have some great info in stock. How does this price sound? It sounds like you're a ripoff, but I'm still taking it. Thank you for your patronage. Apparently a monster inside of Rhoda Blast Furnace has the fury. Take care now. Uh-huh. Now let's see what awaits us in this place.
Aaron, do you remember anything?
Well, let's go inside for now.
You heard her, guys. Let's go.
Is it actually around here? Up no- yeah, it is. There we go. Should be. This should be like the tower. And if it's like the tower, I hope I don't have to go through that maze. That little spot that I hate. You know, that's similar like this, but it's just a square room. Dang it.
Get ready.
Well, I'm going to try to just kill you. Now they're bulky.
I'm ready.
That kind of sucks.
New data.
You're still weak, even if you are bulky. Ish.
It's not over yet.
And we're done here. Remind me that I need to go and do some training for weapon points later. Since one of our newer areas that we've unlocked has some pretty good it does have this again. Has some pretty good WP amount in it. You know what? I'm just gonna have to just start killing you guys. Just like that. Because you get on my nerves. And honestly, I've had enough of trying to sneak past them.
Can we dodge this? Ha! New data!
Are they too far apart or am I just not close enough? I think they're too far apart. So there's no reason for me to do that.
Here.
So they don't need to see your fireballs.
My turn.
Freezing media.
Keep going.
I'm just here to kill you.
Get ready.
No escape, eh?
Let us begin.
Why did you miss?
No. Next.
You could have killed it if you didn't miss.
Eat this! Now!
Get ready!
Do you know how to do anything other than a fireball? It's all good.
Get ready! Eat this! It's over! A winner is a...
Weak and pathetic. Well, he's not paying attention. No. I saw that coming from the get-go. It's not happening.
Taste my power. That hurt.
I'm ready. I won't let you escape.
I'll show you what I got.
Oh, but I did it.
Should have thought twice about trying to attack me. Okay, let's see. Which way should we be heading? I'm gonna assume we need to go this way. Man, I love it when they're not paying attention to me. It makes things so much simpler. But then you got the ones that pay too much attention to you. Like this bird. Enough of your fireballs. Get more creative moves. That's one down.
Let's go, eh?
Two more to kill.
executing soul.
Brace yourself.
And we're done.
Dust to dust. Splendid.
Seriously, that was just a waste of their time. Jump, Fang. Jump. I thought I'd be able to hit it. But he moved.
Looks like that worked.
Let's do this.
Of course it worked. He was that far away and tried to come at me. It wasn't gonna work for him.
My turn.
Jeez, if you did not have fire defense, that probably would have killed you. But that certainly is. Okay, next area. Hopefully we're close. Cause this seems long enough. Like, there we go. And we are at about 37 minutes in, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it here, and on the next episode we'll pick back up where we left off, and I think we're gonna have a boss fight, so that's good. That's nice. Okay, so that is all the time we have for this episode of Fairy Fencer F Admin Dark Force. If you like this episode, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you all on the next episode.